Hello everyone. I hail from Badruganj, a small town in Bihar, which many of you may not have heard of. As you may imagine, the state of education there was very poor and there were hardly 2-3 schools. So like everybody else there, I studied in a Hindi medium school till class 7. Now in class 8, my parents, they took a courageous decision and sent me to a boarding school nearby. The school, however, was no better. The only thing in English were the textbooks, and hardly people talked in English. I remember the first time I opened my science book, I could not read even the first two lines, as I had studied everything in Hindi till then. It was very, very difficult, trust me. So what did I do? I started writing Hindi meanings of each and every word I would come across. I would even carry a dictionary with me to every class I would go to. Gradually, 3 years passed, and then I enrolled in a school in Kolkata. Now on the first day of the school, as I reach, I see everyone in the class talking in English. I was very, very nervous. My legs were shivering. So as I entered, I went straight to the last bench and sat alone. Now the class started with our class teacher asking everyone's introduction. So when it was my turn, I stood up and I introduced. Hello, I am Ashish and I'm from Bihar. As I spoke, everyone in the class, literally everyone in the class started laughing. I did not realize why until a friend told me that your name is Ashish and not Ashish. It was kind of strange to know that I was pronouncing even my own name incorrectly for 15 years. For those of you who have been to Bihar would know that we pronounce S instead of SH. So for Sham, we would say Sam. That night, when I came back, I cried a lot. However, that incident did not deter my confidence. I was adamant I would improve my communication skills. I started reading books out aloud so that I could hear my own pronunciation. I would talk to anyone and everyone in English and ask for their feedback. I would even stand in front of a mirror and try to talk to myself in English. This process might seem easy to you, but trust me, it was very, very difficult. What kept me going were those two lines by Harivansh Rai Bachchan. That lehro se darkar nauka paar nahi hoti. Lehro se darkar nauka paar nahi hoti. Koshish karne walo ki kabhi haar nahi hoti, kabhi haar nahi hoti. So, while I was going through all these, one thing that I always focused on was academics. As I believed, academics is something that could change my life and it could give me an identity. So I worked really hard in class 12 and I secured a 98% and was declared as West Bengal commerce topper. I was felicitated by the governor of West Bengal and got an admission into the prestigious Sri Ram College of Commerce, New Delhi. Now at SRCC, the competition literally doubled. There were toppers from across the country who were good at both academics and communication skills. And now on the other side, there was me, who was struggling with his English and did not know what to do in life. So I knew that I had to improve my personality. I started focusing more on extracurriculars. So let's say dramatics, which helped me gather confidence. Fest, where I met and mingled with a lot of people. And college competitions, where I implemented these learnings. Now in the second year of college, I wanted to capture the stories of people who have overlooked what people say about them and are doing amazingly well in their lives. So with that thought, I started LogKyaKahenge. It's a storytelling series on Instagram where I interview random people and ask for their LogKyaKahenge moment. I aspire to motivate people to not think about what people say and rather focus on becoming better each day. Now in the third year of college, while I was filling my CAT form, I got to know that in Bihar, Marwadis are considered OBC. So a few friends suggested, Ashish, why don't you apply for OBC? That certificate would mean that even if I secure less percentile, I might get into top business schools. Yes, that thought was really tempting. And I should confess that I got carried away. I called my parents and I told them about this. And my parents told me just one thing. They said no. They said this certificate is meant for those who are not financially sound. And we would not misutilize this certificate. There were a lot of thoughts that were going on in my mind. I was in a complete dilemma. I did not sleep for 2 nights. And then on the 3rd day, I just closed my eyes and imagined myself 10 years down the line. And I asked myself that one question. Ashish, will you be happy taking a decision without your parents' support? The answer was loud and clear, and I did not avail that certificate. Now, as they say, when you really want something, so in my case, it was MBA, when you really want something, the whole world conspires in helping you to achieve that. So with all the hard work and rigor, today, here I am, pursuing my MBA from SPJIMR. So from not being able to say my name properly, to today, being in front of you guys, and trying to tell you my story, and that too in English, is an achievement for me. Thank you so much. And thank you to my parents. Thank you.